Hello everybody and welcome to the first episode of season 2 with Cheddar FC. In this summer I tried to sign some better players for this division, but I failed. So we are starting with one signing and the rest of the squad is still the same as last season, and with that we have some pretty high expectations from the board. We need to finish in the top 2 of our division, reach the first qualifying round of the Emirates FA Cup, the third round of the FA Vase, which is highly doubtful and very much a testimony of the luck we have in the draw, and reach the final of the Western League Cup. So it will be a tough season, but I think we should be able to perform like expected. If we look at our competition, we are previewed to finish second with only Larkhall above us, who was relegated from the league above, and are just a little bit better odds, and have a little bit better odds. So there is a chance, but as you can see, same as last year, no players of ours in the media Dream 11. One player from Larkhall, you would say, yes, and that's it. So it will be a challenge, and of course with lower league saves, especially with a custom database, with every turnover the opposition gets better, because they will also find new players, and we don't, because we already signed the better free players there are out there. So we need to get a good start, and hopefully then we will see some better players yet again. The transfers I made, Matt Aldering has left us, Charlie Marsh was already here, I think, at the end of last episode, and he is not that good as opposed to what the staff said when I tried to sign him. That's also the case with Max Dyke. Excuse me. He was told to have 5-star current ability, 5-star potential ability, with a potential ability to be a good player for the Vanarama North and South. This is two divisions lower, so we will have to see. And in the squad comparison, he is second to Talak, who is, I believe, one of the older players with no more potential. So eventually he will leave the squad. And here we have the squad with Talak, of course, in the first team. And our new player, not yet. We will change that immediately. And Danny May is injured, sadly. He did perform very well in the matches pre-season. He is quite strong in all the set pieces. So it will be a bit of a challenge without him. But I think our squad would be good enough to try and beat everybody, especially at home. But you would say also in away games, we should have the number on any of the opposition. Of course, I don't know any of the opposition, so it's not only unknown for me, but also probably for you. So I don't have expectations as of yet. I don't know how many episodes we will do this season. I don't know what matches will be fun to watch. But of course, the first matches will always be done as an episode. So here we go with our first league match against Tavistock, who of course I don't know anything about. And you know, all our players are still the same as last year, with Dijk as the exception. So we're favorites for this match, of course. We should be favorites every match, except for maybe the away match against the top four in the division. So let's see then why. I will change the highlights at the start of the match. You're welcome. And here we go. It was a tough start to the second season. I had 5 weeks in which I had 30 trialists every week. So I seen 150 new players. There were 3 players good enough to sign. We signed one of them. So I spent my time analyzing, debating, trying to negotiate contracts, trying to find players I needed, and all that. I think I've been busy for about an hour or 6. And I signed one player. Bit of a letdown. I hope this one finds the back of the net. It does. In the preseason friendlies, we had 6 penalties. Our opposition had 4 penalties. We scored 1 of them, and our opposition didn't score any of them. So I was a bit of let down by that, and afraid that the latest patch did something to ruin penalty taking, but thankfully now it did work. And let's be honest, in pre-season matches it doesn't really matter if you win or lose. The pre-season matches are primarily for making a bit of money if you play against bigger teams, which I didn't. And making your players match fit. That was a bit of a surprising way of continuing the play from the keeper. But thankfully we still have the ball. Mando tries to shoot from range, but doesn't find space. We're quite slow in our way of playing, which is not something I said they should do. I did find the option of being patient, so I hope we have a better ratio of shots on target, and eventually ook the goals we score, instead of them always going for the first option. I would like them to go for the best option. This match after 45 minutes is not really a testimony of a change in composure. So I will tell them they can do better. And hopefully they do. Most of the matches we played at the end of last season, but also the friendlies. And maybe as well this match. Are won in the second half, in which we play much better than the first half. Except for maybe the last 10 minutes of the match, where we see a little bit of, yeah, I don't know what we see actually. A trade-off maybe between players who are not really on top of their energy levels anymore, who are not performing to the best of their ability because of that, and players who I substituted in and who are then almost obligated to go for their own chances. And here we scored our third goal. It's a nice one, actually. But the way I see it, my players should not be more or extra tired than the opposition. Most of the time we are in possession, and most of the time, just like now, we don't play that much of a pressing system, or at least the players don't do it. It is something I told them to do, but it's not something I see when I watch highlights. Despite that, you can see now after 70 or 80 minutes the first players that are getting tired are very much visible, and now in the 86th minute also Mando is exceptionally tired. Ward as well, so both of the central midfielders, and that of course could be a reason why we struggle in the later stages of the match. But this match we won 3-0, so you would say a good start of the season, good for morale of course. And they did not see that coming. Then they clearly did not see pre-season expectations. Unbelievable result. Very good senior debut from Dijk. That I can agree with. And our biggest opponent did win, but not by much. A dominant victory is always a nice one, of course. And if you look at the league table again, there will only be one team being promoted with no playoff spots whatsoever, and two more teams in total in the division. So instead of 38 matches, we will play 42. And to start off our season, we have a midweek match right off the bat, an away match, which we will also do live. Old Down lost their first match this season, so we should be able, hopefully, to add to their misery. And as you can see, we have a tight schedule in August with 8 matches in the first 4 weeks of the competition. I will scout the Carabao Cup. I don't know why, because I don't care about the Carabao Cup. And I will scout the under-23s for the players leaving their clubs at the end of the season. It's not that we are able to sign players as of now who are leaving the youth academies of the Premier League, but eventually I hope they will come. Those are most of the time the better players you can have in your squad. And of course, the younger the player, the better, because then we have in a possibility of having them for a long time in our squad, which of course is always better long term. And long term, this save will be getting very difficult with the new Brexit rules. If we start off well and we do it soon, we hopefully don't see much of it. But if I look at the let's plays of other people, it will be tough, to say the least. So of course we will just do the opposition instructions. The two changes to the team are not really what I would do myself. On paper he is better, and he is not, so I don't know why it's not because of their fatigue levels or what. I don't know, maybe it is because they were not really performing as the rest of the team did last match out, but it should be good enough. And we played well last match, so why change? Never change a winning team, you would say. I know a Muntari, but I don't think that would be him. I think he's too good to be in the Western League. So again, I don't know any of the opposition. I do know my players now. I also know which one I would like to sub into the squad. And that is, of course, being helped by the fact that we did not sign any players for a long time now. The start of the first season was a bit hectic with the new players, but I'm happy with the squad as it is. And I cannot find players who are better and who are willing to come. Maybe one nice thing to know. Is that all the players, and that was a bit of a strange goal, but I'll take it. Most of the players did have a number of offers from other clubs, but they all stayed. So that's a good sign. We are able to afford a little bit higher appearance fees. And I signed some new contracts with some of the players to try and make sure they don't leave us. In the hope that we promote again this season, I signed them on a contract for after this one runs out. So after, that's a nice one as well. So after the end of the season, it's a bit of a cheat, but it's in the game, so why don't you use it? If it's there, it's there. So the players who I signed for next season have a bit of a higher appearance fee, but for this season it's still the €20 I was able to sign them for last season. Dijk, despite being quite a good player, has also signed for €20 a match. And for next season, some of the players will earn €50 a match. I could go up to 75. But I don't think our finances will be that much better. Of course, again, 3-0 at the moment. Of course, if our expectations of the cup competitions are correct and we are able to get quite far in them, it will be. And the fourth goal, nice. It will be good for our finances, but still, I don't think it will be good enough to give them all a higher appearance fee. And that's the hat trick for Jamal Adams, first hat trick of the season. It was a nice assist as well. And this time we will substitute our midfield in the hopes that the players are fit again for our weekend match. Almost all positions are well taken care of. In squad depth, but of course, you would not start with your second best 11 if you don't really have to. And that's the fourth goal of the match for Adams, who did not score very much last season. So we are off to a good start now. And then hopefully the other strikers will score that much as well. That would be a good sign to come. Zach Jose is our vice captain. He was player of the season last season. He was signing of the season last season. But on paper, he is our fourth best striker. And of course, if he shows me he is still performing better, he will be seeing a lot of minutes to play. But at the start of the season, of course, you want to perform as well as you can. And form is not really a thing at the start of the season. So you have to base it on other things. And Adams is a bit better, especially in finishing. So we have won our second match of the competition. And if we then look at the clubs who already played two matches, there are four clubs who won both of them. I think the rest of the matches for the second round will be played this Wednesday. So we will have a little look as to whether or not I'm correct in that assumption. Record for goals in a game was 3 away to Exmouth in 2020. Scott Brice. So we are straight away in the record books, which of course is always nice. Competitions still not played all. Of course, it's 1 o'clock now, so we will have to wait a little bit longer. And here you have it: Larkhall against Cadbury Heath is the match we are most interested in, of course, as being the one team who have a better outcome. And they drew against Cadbury, so that's a good sign of a good start this season. Our goal difference is already quite something, so that's also nice. And if we do a season preview, at the moment we are first, Bridgwater in second, and Larkhall in third. So if we go and see our schedule, Bridgwater is our next opponent. So next episode we will start with the Bridgwater game, and after that I will probably play some matches for myself, and we will see if we have a match against some good opposition. Maybe get Cadbury Heath away because they took away some points from our opposition. But for the moment, this will be the end of this episode. I hope you all have a great weekend, and see you next time.